how does a swimmer swim? That is, how does a swimmer move forward in water? Well, we know that for the swimmer to move forward, a force needs to be applied on the swimmer in the forward direction. But the swimmer pushes the water backwards. That is, the swimmer exerts a force on the water in the backward direction. So what pushes the swimmer forward? Who or what is exerting the forward force on the swimmer? You would be surprised to know that it is the water which is pushing the swimmer forward. The water applies the force in the forward direction on the swimmer. And because of this force, the swimmer is moving forward. So over here, we saw that the swimmer exerts a backward push on the water, and the water exerts a forward push on the swimmer. And since the water exerts the forward push in response to the backward push by the swimmer, the force exerted by the swimmer on the water is known as the action. And the force exerted by the water on the swimmer is known as the reaction. And for every action, there is a reaction. Yes, for every action, there is a reaction. So even when we push a wall, the wall pushes us back. Do not believe me? Why don't you try out this small, easy experiment? Sit on a chair which has wheels at the bottom and push the wall. What would you observe? You would observe that you are pushed backwards. Now again, in order for you to move backwards, a force needs to be exerted on you in the backward direction. So what or who was exerting this force in the backward direction? Yes, even though it sounds surprising, but it was the wall which was pushing you backwards. So here again, the force exerted by the boy on the wall is the action. And since the wall responds by pushing the boy backwards, so the force exerted by the wall on the boy is the reaction. And so for every action, there is a reaction. And we have noticed that the action and reaction are in opposite direction. So when the swimmer was pushing the water backwards, the water was pushing the swimmer forwards. Again, when the boy was pushing the wall in the forward direction, the wall was pushing the boy back in the backward direction. Further, is there any relationship between the magnitudes of the action and reaction forces? Well, let us repeat our previous experiment to find that out. Once again, push the wall, but this time push it harder. What do you observe? You observe that you are pushed more backwards. That is, when the action was greater, the reaction was greater. And hence, the magnitudes of action and reaction are directly proportional to each other. Now, what is the exact relationship between the magnitudes? For that, let us conduct another experiment. We take two spring balances. What is a spring balance? A spring balance is an instrument which measures the force by which it is being pulled. So here, we take two spring balances. We attach one spring balance to the wall, and the other spring balance is in the hand of this boy who is going to exert a force. Now observe what happens when both the spring balance are connected to each other and this spring balance is pulled. See, you observe that both the spring balances are showing some reading. See, this is spring balance 1 and this is spring balance 2. Let's see how do we understand this reading. What spring balance 2 shows is is the measure of the force by which it is being pulled by spring balance 1. And spring balance 1 is showing the measure of the force exerted by spring balance 2 on it. And why are these forces there in the first place? Well, this boy is pulling this spring balance. When he is pulling this spring balance, in return, the spring balance 1 is pulling spring balance 2. And this is the action force. And the magnitude of the action force is given here. And this is 5 newtons. Now when spring balance 1 pulls spring balance 2, the spring balance 2 also pulls back spring balance 1. This is because of the action reaction forces that we talked about. And the reading on spring balance 1 gives the measure of this pull. And observe that the reading on spring balance 1 is also 5 newtons. So what did we see here? Well, the action force is the force exerted by 1 on 2. And the reaction force is the force exerted by 2 on 1. And notice that both the magnitudes are equal. Hence, the magnitude of the action is equal to the magnitude of the reaction. And to sum up these experiments, we have Newton's third law of motion, which states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Yes, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Now there are a few points to keep in mind. Always note that the magnitude of the action and reaction are equal because for every action there is an equal reaction. Also, the action and reaction are in opposite direction. So when the swimmer was pushing the water backwards, the water was pushing the swimmer forwards. The action and reaction are in opposite direction. Now, what happens when two boys pull this box from the opposite directions? We assume here that the forces exerted by these boys are equal. What do you expect to happen? Well, as expected, the box does not move. Why is that so? That was because the forces cancelled each other. When equal forces act in opposite direction, the forces cancel out each other. So why don't the action and the reaction forces cancel out each other? Even they are equal in magnitude and they are opposite in direction. Well, that is because the action and reaction forces act on different bodies. While the action force is acting on the water, the reaction force is acting on the swimmer. And hence, they do not cancel out. So this is very important to note. So Newton's third law states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. And the action and reaction act on different bodies.